brought to you by Geetanjali Salon, Channi, Himmat, Jammu. Follow Ruchika Makeovers on Facebook and Instagram for best bridal makeup in town.
Hello viewers, you're watching Jammu Links News. I'm Manat Gupta and welcome to the daily updates of Midday News. Let's begin.
Jammu and Kashmir saw a drop in the number of active COVID-19 cases on Tuesday as 14 patients were discharged from hospitals and only 8 fresh cases were detected in the Union Territory. The total number of novel coronavirus cases now stand at 278. 14 patients were also discharged from hospitals in Kashmir and sent to home quarantine as per the standard operating procedure. Two persons, including a doctor, tested positive for the novel coronavirus in Jammu on Tuesday, taking the number of cases in the division in Jammu and Kashmir to 50 on Tuesday. Both of them are employees of a private hospital and they had come in contact with a woman who was admitted there and later tested positive for COVID-19 on Sunday. Jammu and Kashmir Lieutenant Governor G.C. Murmu on Tuesday interacted with doctors and sought their suggestions on the ways to contain the spread of COVID-19. Reaching out to the doctors through a video conference, Murmu called for sustained efforts across the board and escalating the preventive efforts to fight against coronavirus effectively. The Lieutenant Governor asked the doctors and paramedics to ensure that their own safety while treating the patients and assured the administration would provide PPE and N95 masks, gloves and other protective gears to them. Jammu and Kashmir Lieutenant Governor Girish Chandra Murmu on Tuesday interacted with traders and representatives of various associations. At the outset, the representatives of various associations lauded the efforts of the Union Territory Administration under the Lieutenant Governor for containing the spread of COVID-19 in Jammu and Kashmir. Murmu, while interacting with the representatives of the association, assured them that all the genuine demands and issues projected by them would be looked into on priority. He observed that a committee has already been constituted for resumption of commercial and industrial activity in a controlled manner. Union Minister Dr. Jitendra Singh has disclosed that the Jammu and Kashmir's corona testing capacity has increased to over 350 samples per day, which is a major achievement because till about 2-3 weeks back, there was facility of testing hardly 50 samples a day. After a detailed audio interaction regarding corona healthcare facilities in J&K, Dr. Jitendra Singh lauded the Union Territory Government of Jammu and Kashmir, particularly the health authorities, for bringing about a major upsurge in their corona care and prevention capacity during the lockdown period. He complimented the health administration and the dedicated team of UT's medical professionals. He also appreciated Financial Commissioner Health J&K Atal Dullo for his diligent follow-up and close coordination with central government authority. Martyrdom of Pashid Iqbal will not go in vain. Sacrificing his life, Iqbal has set up an example for others to follow. The perpetrators of the crime will not be spared at any cost. This was stated by Ravinder Raina, President Jammu and Kashmir Bharatiya Janata Party, during his visit at Government Medical College to inquire about the health of the injured police jawan Vishal Singh, who was severely injured in a terrorist attack in Dachin area of Kishtwar. Director General of Police Dilbagh Singh chaired a high-level meeting with the officers of different wings to finalize the arrangements and preparedness regarding the annual Darbar move. During the meeting, the DGP said that all wings of J&K Police who are supposed to open their offices in the annual Darbar move in the summer capital of Union Territory are directed to prepare a list of officers and officials who will move to the Srinagar. As many as 204 prisoners, including 45 who were arrested under the Stringent Public Safety Act, were released this month to decongest jails across Jammu and Kashmir in the wake of COVID-19 pandemic. In addition, the Home Department has also revoked the PSA of 41 prisoners who are held in different jails outside the Union Territory and ordered their release. In the wake of lockdown triggered by COVID-19 pandemic, Jammu Municipal Corporation has started the process of feeding stray animals in and around Jammu city. In this regard, JMC Commissioner Abni Lavasa visited Narwal Bypass, Channi, Bahukot, Transport Nagar and adjoining areas to inspect the feeding of stray animals. A handout stated that JMC is daily providing green fodder sources from RS Pura and surrounding areas and vegetables waste from Narwal Mandi to the stray cattle. Apart from this, JMC officials are feeding stray dogs with biscuits and other food materials on daily basis. Samba Police has come up with a unique initiative, the first of its kind in UT of J&K, and launched a mobile sanitizer vehicle to protect its police personnel from getting infected by the deadly disease. The vehicle will also be pressed into service for the public at large in view of growing threat from COVID-19. The mobile sanitizer vehicle will be used for sanitizing policemen deployed at frontline, quarantine centers, high-risk zones, border police posts and at other checkposts. Police personnel manning the streets during the COVID-19 lockdown are at high risk of contracting the deadly virus, and the vehicle is specially designed for catering to the policemen on duty, a handout said. A woman from Nandana village of Thathri area delivered a baby in 108 dial ambulance. The 108 dial ambulance was launched by the District Development Doda under Bharti Vilas Group as free service for the people. The purpose of this ambulance service is to ensure that delivery of public healthcare services to the patients at their doorstep. The woman and her child are healthy, he said, adding that this was the second delivery case in 108 dial ambulance since it's launched by the district administration under the supervision of Lieutenant Governor J&K G.C. Murmu. District Development Commissioner Nazim Zay Khan on Tuesday distributed PP kits and personal as well as community sanitation material among NGOs and frontline workers who are rendering their services to prevent COVID-19. DDC informed that administration has involved the PRIs and NGOs to intensify sanitation drives in rural areas of district beside ensuring effective implementation of guidelines issued by the health department in this regard. While their both parents are serving the people in hospitals amid coronavirus scare, Saiba and Saisha, twin sisters in Jammu, are creating awareness about importance of social distancing and other precautions needed to be taken to prevent ourselves from this dreaded virus. Saiba and Saisha Gupta study in Presentation Convent Senior Secondary School, Gandhinagar in Jammu, and recently appeared in 10th standard board exams. Amid lockdown due to coronavirus spread, the twin sisters composed three songs to raise awareness among people, the latest being on health workers, in which they expressed their gratitude to their doctors and health workers for their phenomenal work during this difficult time. The IMF on Tuesday projected a GDP growth of 1.9% for India in 2020 as the global economy hits the worst recession since the Great Depression in the 1930s due to the raging coronavirus pandemic that has nearly stalled all economic activities across the world. With this subdued forecast, India is likely to record its worst growth performance since the 1991 liberalization, but this International Monetary Fund, in its latest edition of the World Economy Report, has placed India as the fastest growing emerging economies of the world. US President Donald Trump on Tuesday announced halting America's funding of the World Health Organization while a review is being conducted to assess its role in severely mismanaging and covering up the spread of the deadly coronavirus. The novel coronavirus, which originated from Wuhan city of central China's Hubei province in November, has so far killed at least 1,19,000 people globally, including more than 25,000 in the United States. A total of 90 red zones have been identified in Jammu and Kashmir as of April 14th. The 90 red zones, 14 in Jammu and 76 in Kashmir, are distributed across 13 districts, including Jammu, Rajouri, Udhampur, Bandipora, Baramulla, Shopian and Srinagar, among others.